Hello, I'm Pantelis Mitropoulos from Geospatial Enabling Technologies. I will present a work in progress, an automated profiling software for large geospatial data, the Big Data Buoyant. Big Data Buoyant is an open source, extensible and scalable Python library for data profiling over various types of geospatial data, as you will see in a while. Generally speaking, data profiling is a collection of operation processes for extracting metadata for a given dataset in a way that facilitates decision-making on its potential utilization. Usually, this process involves extraction of schema information, statistics upon various attributes of the dataset, depending, of course, on their data type, and also extraction of samples. The extracted information usually accompanied by visualizations such as tables, charts, timelines, etc., for better understanding of the results. Profiling has attracted a lot of interest recently with the rise of big data. However, the focus is on relational or tabular data, overlooking the specific requirements of geospatial data. Profiling a big data asset is a challenge by itself, added to other important challenges of profiling in general. For example, handling input data from heterogeneous sources is not trivial at all, as well as dealing with the computational complexity and scalability of profiling. Moreover, interpreting the output profiles typically requires domain expertise and may depend on the use case, for example, exploration, integration, etc. Although general profiling libraries do not focus on geospatial data, many GIS software platforms already offer some profiling capabilities with the support of the exploratory spatial data analysis tool. However, data profiling in GIS platforms is not streamlined, but may involve manual execution of a series of operations. Moreover, step-by-step user intervention is necessary. Here we see an example of creation of heat map in QGIS. QGIS is a desktop GIS application. Although QGIS is open source, many other advanced GIS platforms require to obtain a software license with a cost that in many cases could be prohibitive. Having this in mind, we designed Big Data Buoyant as an open source, interactive, modular, and extensible framework specifically tailored for in-depth profiling of geospatial data. It allows data scientists to control its degree of automation, either choosing a step-by-step mode, either using a fully automated configuration. Big Data Buoyant supports different types of spatial assets in various formats. I will open a parenthesis here to say some things about these types of spatial datasets. The most common types of spatial data are vectors and rasters. Vectors could be seen as usual tabular data with an extra component, the geometric component. This component could contain points, lines, polygons, and their multi-counterparts, multi-points, multi-lines, etc. On the other hand, rasters are grids of regularly sized pixels, for example, satellite imagery or aerial photos, or thematic rasters, such as the digital elevation model. Rasters are organized in bands. For example, we could have a three-band raster interpreted in the red, green, blue color model, or more specialized interpretation of bands, for example, in multispectral bands for scientific observations. There is also a third type of spatial dataset, the multidimensional. Multidimensional assets are usually array-based scientific data containing values, for example, from sensor measuring or results from physical modeling. The profiling framework has the profiler engine in its core, which is our main focus of development for the moment. We will see the profiler engine in some detail later on. Using the profiling framework, the data analyst could ingest a geospatial dataset and apply a set of processing tasks. The resulting metadata includes statistics in JSON format, geospatial features in a well-known text representation or JSON representation, and maps as static PNG images or dynamic objects. For vector data, profiling can be applied in different fashions to automatically compute metadata. First, regarding the whole dataset, we have a feature count and samples of the dataset. Here we treat the dataset as a whole. Regarding the geometries, we could have the native coordinate reference system of geometries, the spatial extent, the alpha shapes, various alpha shapes for the extent of the geometries, etc. Finally, we examine the thematic attributes where relational data profiling could be applied. Examples here are the attribute types, the cardinality, which is the count of non-null values per attribute, and other things like this. In a similar manner for raster datasets, we have the native CRS, which describes the raster dataset as a whole. We have raster-specific metadata, such as the resolution, a number of bands, etc. I remind here that rasters are typically organized in one or more bands, so we have, in this sense, band-related metadata. Characteristic such metadata are value distribution, the histogram of the raster values, band statistics, and other things. We move on multidimensional spatial datasets. Just to say a few things before we see the metadata on these assets. Multidimensional datasets have dimensions which represent real physical dimensions, as for example, the spatial coordinates or time, or more specific, model specific dimensions, and also have variables which hold multidimensional arrays of values of the same type, and they depend on the dimensions. Again, here we have metadata which describe the whole dataset, as for example, the native, again, coordinate reference system, the dimension information, and variable-related metadata, as is the spatial and temporal extent, the value distribution, and the known data value for the variables. I will proceed on the implementation status, describing the architecture. As I mentioned before, our main focus for the moment is the profiler engine. The profiler engine leverages various Python libraries to offer an API for automated metadata extraction and manipulation. Starting from the right, we use for multidimensional data a Python library to connect with an HDFC library for multidimensional data. GDAL for rasters. GDAL is a very common and powerful library for reading and write geospatial data. I will start a little more on vector datasets, because they proved more challenging in terms of handling large datasets. In this case, we had to develop our own library, which was based on VIEX. VIEX is a high-performance Python library to visualize and explore big tabular datasets. Therefore, we developed GeoVIEX in order to address scalability for vector datasets. GeoVIEX reads and processes spatial files in a memory-efficient manner using Apache Arrow inter-process communication for manipulating big datasets. Once the software reaches a stable level, we plan an extensive empirical study. However, our preliminary results show that it scales very well for large datasets. The key features for this library, as I said, it extends the VIEX library, introducing numerable spatial methods such as spatial joins, spatial relational predicates, and geometric constructive operations. The native GeoVIEX natively reads and writes files in Arrow format. However, in order to be able to import and export common geospatial formats. We use GDAL from OSGeo. And finally, GeoVax integrates PyGeo's recent library for geometric manipulations. PyGeo supports real multi-threading and NumPy universal functions, making even a single-threaded operation much faster than other approaches. Here we see an example of running the software. In this particular example, we opened a shape file containing something less than 26 million features. This file is about 8 gigabytes in size, which is the upper limit for a shape file. Below, we can see a thumbnail generated by the library just to give an impression of this data set. Below this, a random sample has been extracted with just 3 features. But what is important here is to see how the data sets appear to the user. First, we have the attribute component, and below this, we have the geometry component with geometries in the well-known text representation. In the middle, we have information about the coordinate reference system of the geometries. And below, a bar chart with the distribution of an attribute of the polygons. On the right panel, we have 2 maps. On the top is a heat map, and below this is a clustering. For the moment, for the clustering, we support DBSCAN, HDBSCAN, and TopTics algorithms, but we plan to extend the algorithms that we use. One can choose to export these maps as static PNG images, choosing also the base map of his choice. But I think most noteworthy is the export to GeoJSON, even for the heat map, keeping the styling. Regarding our ongoing work, we would like to handle vector data with more than 2 spatial dimensions to improve and extend clustering. We would like to examine whether clustering free parameters could be automatically calculated in a data-driven manner according to data characteristics. We would also like to extend the metadata set. For example, examine whether a road network is connected and can support routing, and also have feedback from stakeholders in the geospatial value chain and open source developments. Finally, we would like to complement metadata with more intuitive, interactive visualizations to further improve their cognitive interpretation. This work was started for covering the needs in the context of Opertus Multi project. Opertus Multi aims to offer a trusted, robust, and scalable pan-European geospatial data marketplace, the Topio market. Metadata extracted for such datasets give information to their potential buyers about the coverage, the timelines, consistency and completeness, as well as domain-specific properties, such as topology, scale, etc. These are crucial for the entire life cycle of spatial asset provision, discovery, sharing, purchasing, and use. Big data has been already integrated in the alpha version of Topio Market, and will be also provided as a service with a RESTful API. Thank you very much for your attention.